Welcome back to another class of Microsoft Azure AG104. I am Manjeet Rawat, your online instructor. And in this class, we are going to talk about Azure Marketplace, Azure Subscription, about the resource group, management group, and also we are going to talk about the gap between region and zone and how we can establish and decide to create our resources on which particular zone or which location. I'm sharing my screen, but before that, if you're new on my YouTube channel, you are watching my video first time, please do subscribe, because Teach Me Cloud is a single technical training based YouTube channel that give you 100% live practical based video without skipping any step. I hope everyone able to see my screen. Let's talk about, this is day 2 of Microsoft Azure Administrator journey. And in this class, we are going to talk about few important points related to the Azure. Right, the first one, let's talk about Azure subscriptions, right? The number of subscriptions that we have that we can use to create our account. And then we'll talk about resource group. Yes, this is really important. You should know about the use case of resource group. Then we are going to talk about management group, about the region and zone. Then we'll talk about Azure Marketplace, right? So these all points we are going to discuss in this class. In case of subscription, you know that every cloud platform, I'm not talking about only for Microsoft Azure, even you are going to establish your account over Amazon Web Services or Google Cloud, you must need to purchase at least one subscription. Microsoft will give us option to purchase free trial account. Yes, the first one is free trial. Second is pay as you go, right? Pay as you go. And the third important part, you can say that MSDN, right? So free trial account is basically will give you $200 for 30 days, right? You have a much amount and you have a valid a duration, like 30 days is enough to learn how Microsoft Azure services can work. To create your free trial account, to avail our $200 for your practical purpose, you just need to use your credit and debit card, your personal contact detail and email ID, and you can sign up and get $200. Pay as per use. Yes, it will help you to provide services as per the requirement, and you have to pay the amount or bill as per the usage. Next, MSDN is applicable for MCT, Microsoft Certified Trainer. $100, you will get $100 every month, right? If you are MCT, then definitely use your same email ID that you earlier used to complete your certification of MCT. In the same email ID, you will get $100 per month. The another important topic, which is resource group. This is really important. Azure portal will authorize you to create any resources or virtual machine. It's mandatory to create a resource group. So you can say that it's a type of container, right? So in the container, we can that help us to contain Alright, so like you are going to establish your own virtual machine, you are going to purchase database, you are going to establish a kind of VNet, firewall, or any type of services that you are going to purchase from the Azure portal, resource group must be coming into the picture. Let me show you one practical example, not practical, like give you the real scenario. This is your Microsoft Azure portal. Let's take an example, and you are the owner of this portal. You are trying to log in this portal with the help of root account and you have a full access. You are going to provide support to ABC Limited, like private limited. This is the company name. The second company is XYZ Private Limited. And the third company you are going to handle maybe TMC Private Limited, Teach Me Cloud Private Limited. Okay, so these three companies are going to take services from you, from your account. So what you need to do, one resource group RG for ABC company, another resource group you need to create for your XYZ, and one more resource group that you need to create for TMC. And ABC requested, can you please provide me 5 virtual machine? XYZ requested, please provide me 200 TB of storage, and TMC required 1 firewall, right? Or you can say that SQL Server from Azure portal. So let's try to understand, to segregate the services for these companies, these organizations, as an Azure administrator, we should create a 3 different resource group for each and every organization. The benefits to set up our resources on dedicated resource group, that you can easily configure alert, monitor, logs, or you can also identify and segregate the bill for your dedicated organization or dedicated client. In single word, you can say that the resource group is a virtual container which is responsible to contain the resources that you are going to proceed and create for any specific organization. I hope everyone okay with the point that we discussed regarding this resource group. Let's talk about management group. Yes, over a portal, we are able to find both the options. So everyone, this is our Microsoft Azure portal. Day one, your responsibility to create one resource group. You are able to find resource group like I have already created Azure Live 1988. It means that if I'm going to create any service, I'm going to purchase any resource from portal, mandatory you must need to put your service on your on resource group. I'm going to create another resource group, provide your subscription detail, and also resource group name is class Azure class RG, right? Location of this resource group, I'm going to create a location of East US, and this is a just container, right? So once your resource group is ready to use, you need to add your resources, you need to purchase your services from portal and put it into the same container. That will help you in case of billing, that will help you in case of create alert, or you are going to configure any kind of logs detail, then definitely this container will help you. So once our container is ready to use, like one more container we just created with name of Azure class something, Azure class RG, which is fully blank. We are not able to find any resources in this particular container. So let me add one virtual machine. So while create any resource, not only the virtual machine, if you are going to set up your VNet, you are going to purchase storage, any type of services that you are going to create, it will ask you, what's your resource group? What's your container? So I'm going to create my virtual machine in my on resource group. Server 2016, just an example. So I actually, the R is in there to define you the work of resource group, right? Next, review and create. It will take time, like 5 minutes required to create our virtual machine. But meanwhile, let me guide you about the another options that we have. Like as a management group is also important for us. And the work of management group, everyone try to understand the meaning of management group, that will help us to add multiple resources, add multiple subscription with our account. You can segregate subscription and tenant for different employer, for different Azure administrator. So it is in progress and definitely it will take time, validation passed. So it is in progress. Meanwhile, let me open journal tab, right? In journal tab, you will get the access of, click on journal tab. We are able to find marketplace, resource group, subscription, and this is management group. Open the management group panel and it will provide you the details related to your current tenant. Yes, the current tenant that you have, it will show you the details about your current tenant. This is tenant root group, Azure subscription 1, and everything is okay. Do you want to create a new management group? Please click here. provide the detail of your management group. You need to provide the value of your management group. I don't any display name, so I'm going to proceed with the same display name, okay, and submit. One management group is already available with name of tenant root group that associated with the Azure subscription one. This is our subscription that we purchased. This is a definitely free trial, but I'm going to add one more resource group, one more management group, and we'll purchase another subscription and add with the second management group that I'm trying to create. It is in progress. Virtual machine is also in progress. So you have to wait for a few more minutes and you will get the access of our new resource, new management group. And in the management group, we are able to assign another subscription, right? Like you are going to use single user ID and password to provide services to all the clients. Definitely you always proceed with multiple kind of resource management group. Our virtual machine is ready to use, and you know that the virtual machine we created on our own resource group that we created earlier, the resource group is Azure Class RG. If I'm going to open, it will show you the number of services or number of components that you added in this resource group. Web virtual machine, web IP, web NSG, web VNet, NIC card, hard drive, these all components are part of Azure Class resource group. So not only the virtual machine, any kind of services that you are going to purchase or configure, mandatory to set up one resource group and put your resources in the on resource group. As it is, let me show you the management group, I think, which is still in progress. Clear. New management group is ready to use, but unfortunately, no subscriptions added in this management group. The first one is tenant root group. Second one is test management. I'm going to open and it will give you option. Do you want to add any type of subscription? Please click here and it will give us option to add subscription as per the requirement. I'm going to click here. It will ask you and just need to save. Do you want to add the subscription to this management group? Existing subscription will automatically become the part of test management. Means if you have a multiple subscription, right? If you have multiple subscription, like currently we have only one Azure subscription one, but I'm going to buy one more subscription based on pay as you go. So in this case, it will give you option to add one subscription with the default management group, add second subscription for your own management group that you created by yourself. I hope everyone okay with the points that we discussed regarding the management group and resource group. Is that clear? Now let's talk about region and zones, which is really important for everyone. You must need to know about the gap between region and zone. For every Azure administrator, right, it's our responsibility. You know that every cloud providers establish their data center in different geographical location. Let's take an example. This is globe worldwide and n number of data centers are available in the entire world. So we have a region and the second one is zones, right? Regions and zone. The meaning of region, collection of multiple zone. Yes. Let me give you one example. AP, Asia Pacific, is a type of region, right? And in Asia Pacific, we are able to find n number of zones, a small zone. You can also say that the zones are considered as a physical data center, right? That is established by Microsoft Azure. So if I'm going to open my portal and try to create any virtual machine or any service, it will ask you where you want to put it. You must need to decide the region. You must need to provide the zone to create any service from Microsoft Azure. Subscription, and this is the panel, region. If I'm going to open, US is a region, Asia Pacific is a region, Europe is a region, and again Asia Pacific, Europe, Middle East, South America, US. See, in the Asia Pacific, Australia Center, Australia Southeast, Korea South, South India, right? These all are the zones. You can say that the physical data center, like Asia Pacific, but in the Asia Pacific, we are able to find multiple kind of zones like Central India, East Asia, Indonesia, Japan, Japan West, Korea. So these all zones are part of Asia Pacific, right? Asia Pacific region, which is a collection of multiple zones. I hope everyone okay with the concept of zones and region. Let's talk more about it. Next point, topic that we need to understand is Azure Marketplace, right? So as per the name suggests, the work of Azure Marketplace. With the help of Azure Marketplace, you can buy anything, what you want. Do you want to purchase SQL? Do you want to purchase any firewall, switches, router, virtual machine, Windows-based machine, Linux-based machine, any type of operating system, any type, any platform-based computer or devices that you want to purchase, please try to open journal tab. And in journal tab, you just need to click on Marketplace. In the Marketplace, we are able to find multiple options. This is the management, private marketplace, private offer management, and categories. Under the categories, compute services, 5,300 plus services are available in compute. IT and management, security, AI, developer, analytics, web, DevOps, databases, networking, storage, identity. Number of services are available that you can directly buy. Let's try to buy one service. Maybe I'm going to purchase firewall. In the search menu, you just need to type firewall, right? And it will give you the list of firewall, right? We are able to find Cisco firewall and web application firewall. You are going to type any specific model number. Sophos, right? You are going to purchase a Sophos firewall. It will give us access. You just need to purchase Sophos firewall and get the access of GUI and perform all the tasks. Backup related tool that you are going to purchase, backup related tool. Let me check if Datto is available. Barracuda available, right? Okay. So some of the backup tools are available, like let me check Veeam. Whatever that you want to purchase, see, n number of backup services are available related to the Veeam backup. No need to purchase hardware, no need to purchase a license for your backup software. You just need to buy it directly with the help of portal and start using services, right? So this is the work of our Azure Marketplace. I hope everyone okay with the points that we discussed so far in case of class 2. I hope everyone enjoying the playlist there, and definitely in this playlist will make you Azure certified engineer. Definitely you are able to crack the examination of AZ-104. So stay tuned with Teach Me Cloud. We are going to connect on Thursday and discuss more about the Azure portal. Yeah, I'm going to start our modules like identity and governance, storage, compute, virtual network and monitoring. Take care. Bye-bye. Do subscribe here on Teach Me Cloud YouTube channel. Bye, guys.